Hi, Dennis Burns here from Gibson Truck World, the king of trucks. We have the largest selection of trucks at the lowest prices, period. Gibson is the only dealer that inspects, services, and repairs our trucks to make them the safest trucks on the road. With our free one-year bumper-to-bumper warranty, our one-year free maintenance, and our exclusive 15-day return policy, we are guaranteed for what you need. Come see us in Sanford on 1792 or online anytime at GibsonTruckWorld.com. We are the king of trucks.
Hi, I'm Tommy. I've been a tech here at Gibson for 11 years now. I just want to take you on a quick tour of our Disaster Prevention Center, kind of show you a little bit about us, what sets us apart from the rest, how we diagnose everything, why we change some of the parts that we do. Let's start off with our brake pads. Everything gets a brake inspection, and as you can see, this brake pad still has a lot of meat left to it. Not necessarily a bad brake pad, but on something like this, the truck had a brake pulsation. With a brake pulsation, it's an automatic brake job. Pads get changed, rotors get turned, as long as the rotors have enough material left to be machined. Every rotor is inspected. We take and measure our thickness of every single rotor. This will determine and tell us if we're on a path to machine them or if they need to be replaced. This particular rotor was replaced. Not enough material left to machine. You can also see we have a huge pile of tie rod ends here. Everything's inspected for any kind of play. Some of these kits were changed to take care of the death wobble. Manufacturers come up with a new design. That's why you see a lot of these kits in here. We do have ball joints. We check on a regular basis. This particular ball joint, you can see here, just by hand, there's up and down movement in it. This is with no weight of the vehicle on it at all. There are tolerances that we have on most ball joints. It's not a very large number. The largest number we have on one manufacturer is 60 thousandths. Even if we're 25 thousandths, 30 thousandths, once it hits our alignment machine, if there's any kind of movement that changes the numbers on the screen to where it shows any kind of camber or toe change just from playing a component, it's changed. As you can see, we have barrels of tie rod ends, ball joints, control arms. Every single piece you see here has had some kind of play, some kind of problem with it. Your hub bearing is where your rotor goes over, your four-wheel drive front axle comes through. It's the bearing that lets the front wheel roll. Any kind of play, any kind of noise in it, you'll hear a growling noise as you're driving. Any kind of play at all in your hub bearing, we're going to change it, because down the road it's going to get worse, it's going to give you problems, you're going to get tire wear, you can end up with a spongy brake pedal because the excess play lets the rotor lean. When you hit the brakes, it's got to make up that extra distance to give you a firm brake pedal when stopping. Every single truck that comes through the shop is pressure tested. This is a radiator out of a power stroke. Power stroke was known for leaking on the seams right here. As you can see at the bottom, there was a leak in this one. This radiator has been sitting here so you can see, so we can pass that information on to you. If this was something that we neglected to catch and just let it roll out, and you had to take it to the dealer yourself, that's a $1,000 job right there that we just did, that we caught while your truck was in for service. Just an example of the manufacturers doing an update on the steering kit. This is your old Dodge tie rod kit. As you can see, between wheel to wheel, you got three tie rods to where you can have play, excessive movement, tire vibration can help cause a death wobble. The new design now is tie rod, wheel to wheel, two tie rods. The third tie rod ties in, not as much movement between wheel to wheel. We also have our tram gauge. We have manufacturer specifications on what every truck should be. Every truck is checked for peace of mind. This gauge is 16 foot long. We can measure from different spots on the frame, further back, underneath the lower ball joint, from the cross member, measuring the X across one side to the other. Make sure your numbers are right on. This is used every truck that comes in. Make sure we have no issues to where you have no concerns down the road either. Other problems we've seen in our prevention center, this right here is a water pump off of a power stroke. As you can see, the impellers broke off the back. It's just spinning by itself. This right here itself can easily be misdiagnosed as bad EGR cooler, bad head gaskets, clogged radiator. This is just one of the things, we went the extra mile to make sure that we were on the right path. We caught it. This is your oil cooler out of a power stroke. Your 6.0s, your 6.4s, your 6.7s all use a similar design. As you can see, all the openings in here, both water and oil pass through here. All right, this is EGR cooler off of a power stroke. You have exhaust pass through your intake and through this as well. You also have your coolant pass through here as well. The biggest problem you'll see on most power strokes is a temperature variation between the EGR cooler and the oil cooler. We have the same diagnostic equipment that Ford uses, the IDS. We can hook it up to the truck and we can run it and actually watch the temperature between the oil cooler and EGR cooler. Ford allows 14 degrees difference between the two. Most of what we see when we're testing, you're about a 4 degree difference. With 4 degrees, you're not gonna have any problem. One of the biggest problems with your temperature difference between your oil cooler and EGR cooler, you'll notice more under working conditions, hauling heavy loads, pulling heavy trailers. That is the majority of the time you'll see the little wrench light pop on a Ford. It usually indicates there's a temperature variation between the two. Also, seat motors. It doesn't really look like much, but there's three motors per seat, and these little motors can run you $100 a piece. 9 times out of 10, on Dodges, you have two motors go bad, your tilt motors. And if you end up with both seats being power with motors going bad, that's $600 worth of repairs right there on just changing the motors and the seats. So here's our Dodge AC evaporator. You see how nasty it looks right here? This is the weakest point on a Dodge AC unit. Either the oil leaks in here and it collects the dust, or in your dirty, dusty driving conditions, the air coming through collects here and it'll block off your flow and you'll have poor flow coming through your dash. These are the steps you have to go through to change the evaporator in a Dodge pickup. As you can see, the dash has to come almost completely out of the truck just to access the evaporator box. Then you gotta split the evaporator box open just to get to the evaporator itself. This is your new evaporator compared to your old. As you can see, there's no dust collected, anything, air will blow right through it. Now put the heater core back in, put the box back together, and we're ready to install it back into the truck. This job itself is about an 8-hour job at most dealers and can run you $1,000. So as you can see, we have barrels and barrels full of tie rod ends, brake pads, hub bearings, a lot of components just to show you as an example of what we do. What you see in our shop when you look through here, take a tour of it, is about 1 year's worth of saving parts. We've had to quit saving them or else you wouldn't be able to walk through our shop. We'd have piles and piles of old parts just to show you what we do. Again, this is what sets us apart from the rest. We go that extra mile, show you what we do, and we'll be willing to take the time to explain anything you want to know about anything on your truck.